Oh my goodness, we are back. We're sorry for the break. Welcome to EnjoyTheMusic.tv. My name is Stephen Rochlin. We're here with John of Benchmark Media Systems. And John will tell us quite a bit about their new products. They have DACs, they have amps, they have headphones, they have speakers. You guys, like, do it all.
Well, we don't have headphones, but we have headphone amplifiers.
Well, that's what I meant.
No headphones yet.
Oh, but, yet?
No.
Is there something I should?
No.
I was hoping to get some kind of secret.
No secrets from me.
So, now you brought with us, Enjoy the Music's reviewed your amplifiers, your headphone amp DAC, and on. And for the money, they really are incredible, incredible products. What would you like to start talking about first today?
Well, one of the things that we're really excited about is our new power amplifier. We have one room here today where we're showing five of these driving the Salon 2 speakers from Revel. That's a... Just a really fun room to go and visit. We're doing that with AIX Records, so we've got a surround system in there. We're driving those in a bridge mono configuration. And then we have a room upstairs where we're showing our AHB2 in an all benchmark system. It's our D-Day converter.
Right.
Our amplifier and our SMS-1 speakers.
Nice. So let's go ahead and start out. It looks like we're going to be covering the AHB quite a bit. So I actually have a really, really sweet graphic you guys gave me. It's actually a tiny relative unit. I'd say about a, how many, 16 inches?
14? Yeah, it's about 15, 16 inches wide. It's all passively cooled. It's a compact box, but it's an analog amplifier. It's not a switching amplifier. You see a small amplifier like this, and automatically you would assume that it's Class D. It's a Class AB amplifier with feedforward error correction. There's some brand new technologies in this. There's two patents from THX Corporation. We got chatting with them at one of these shows back probably 3-4 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And they caught wind of the fact that we were working on a power amplifier, and they said, hey, we've got some patents that we think you'd be interested in.
Wait, this is,
you can actually lift
neat.
It.
You know, it's makes a nice sound, but no. And here's the back panel, although I have it upside down a bit. But what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead, I'm going to do some camera close-up work so I can show you a little bit better on what actually does comprise this unit. So give me just a second to switch to that, and we'll be right there in a second. Here we go.
Okay, one of the things you'll notice is that there are only balanced inputs on this amplifier.
Mm-hmm.
This is all about performance, and it's important to use the best possible interfaces available. And so the inputs are balanced. We have a set of adapter cables that will adapt to unbalanced inputs. It's a low gain amplifier. It's designed to have high-level studio level signals on a balanced interface feeding it, and that's exactly what our DAC-2 provides. It's also compatible with other preamplifiers by means of this gain switch. There's a 3-position gain switch that will increase the gain in the amplifier.
Nice.
We're talking about an amplifier that's got 135 dB signal-to-noise ratio in bridge mono. There's nothing that comes close to that in terms of being as quiet.
Right, and internally, I mean, everything is really nicely done. You use very large cabling for the speaker outputs. I mean, really well built.
And what you're seeing there is the power supply. You can't actually see the amplifier board in that photograph. The amplifier board is down below it. But the power supply is very compact, as you can see. but it's all designed to have very low magnetic field emissions. So so there's no hum, there's no any line related noise, and it's a fully regulated supply. So as the power line dips, mm-hmm. as the line voltage changes, the output stays constant. If you have a loud musical sequence, you don't lose power as capacitors discharge. This is responding in real time to the loading of the audio.
Right, now the next product you wanted to show us, and we can actually go to your products page, is which?
Well, it'll be the DAC2 HGC. I actually have a DAC2DX here, which is very similar. But there's the HGC, mm-hmm. and this product has a total of five digital inputs and two analog inputs. It has two coaxial inputs, two optical inputs, and a USB input. And the USB input is really important for being able to get audio out of your computer, bit transparent, at up to 192 kilohertz, 24 bits, and also has the ability to play DSD files. We can play DSD through any of the coaxial inputs as well. Mm-hmm. It also has two sets of analog inputs and a total of three analog outputs. Two balanced outputs plus two sets of unbalanced outputs. Gives you volume control, gives you input selection, and a phenomenal headphone amplifier to boot.
And it plays, you know, everything, DSD, 24192, so it really handles pretty much everything you need.
Yeah, one of the things I point out, too, is the fact that it's got a sample rate and word length indicator on it. These are such good diagnostic tools
yes.
for figuring out, you know, is my computer putting out what I expect it to, or is
yep.
it getting dumbed down? A lot of DVD players dumb the output down to 4416, and you don't know it. You sense something's wrong, but how do you know?
Oh, it's true.
And that's what the display shows you.
Yeah, it happens with home and portable and whatnot, is you never really know what really is going out without an indicator. And mm-hmm. I've been occurring that with certain pieces of gear I'm not going to name, but it is incredibly useful to know what are you really getting.
Yeah.
And what was the other piece of gear you wanted
to
introduce?
Well, the other one is this one here, which is the DAC2DX.
Okay.
It's a little bit different than the HGC. One of the differences is that if we look at the back panel, mm-hmm. it has an AES balanced XLR input. Now, this is a...
Wow, you have a lot of photos for this.
A lot of photos of it, and if you keep going there, you can see that it's...
There we go.
Right in the center is the AES input. This particular product is a digital-only product. It doesn't have any analog inputs.
Mm.
A lot of these are being used in recording studios, and a lot of professional applications, they needed the balanced XLR input. We're also using these down in the AIX room because we're running three DAC2DXs from a JRiver media server that has AES outputs on it.
Wow.
So we have bit transparent 24-bit audio coming out of the server in 5.1 surround going
nice.
To three of these DAC2DXs. And out to five AHB2 power amplifiers and into the five Salon 2 loudspeakers.
Wow.
Just a phenomenal system down there, and the room sounds great.
Yeah, it's, you know, again, one of the things I've always admired with Benchmark is you guys are, you're really on top of it all.
Well, our goal is to build transparent gear that's, we don't sit down and say, okay, here's the budget to build mm-hmm. this. We sit down and say, what is it we want to do? What are the specifications going to be? And we'll list all those specifications out, and then figure out what do we have to do to make it happen.
Wonderful.
And, so that's our approach.
great. Any last words or anything else you'd like to tell our viewers today?
Well, I'd like to thank you for having us here today, and everything that your magazine does to promote the industry, and it's great to be here at the show. We've been having a great, fun time.
Awesome. Thank you so much. We do appreciate it. And I'll go ahead and I'll switch it to me. My name is Stephen Rochlin of enjoythemusic.com and enjoythemusic.tv. And instead of going to a star field, as always, in the end, what really matters is that you enjoy the music.